Hello, welcome back. I'm Ursa Ryan, and I'm hoping that we can finish this game off this session. I hope you guys are all well. I'm good. It's the weekend. Got some time off. It's really good. I've been on holiday and sort of busy doing things and whatever over the last couple of weeks. So this Bear Grylls campaign has been very much a nice little segue, low effort, diversion to being able to put content up regularly on the channel. But I'm going to start filming the next AI Only campaign very soon. So fingers crossed you guys will enjoy that as well. You join us today on the dawn of fascism because, you know, fascism in Civ 6 is great. Whereas in real life, it's clearly great. I don't know. I've kind of gone for a weird mixture of policies with fascism. So we've got the usual ones like propaganda, we've got martial law, both of these things reducing war weariness because Bear Grylls can never slow down. Levy on mass to keep gold coming in. We've got national identity to stop the combat penalty from injury. Wars of religion because that gives us extra combat in a lot of situations as well. Not all situations, but a lot of situations. Oligarchic legacy, of course, giving us the extra +4, liberalism helping with immunities, merchant confederation getting us money, and we've gone for two more. We've gone for simultaneum to get extra faith, and I'll show you why in a second, and then three market to get extra gold. I think that is going to be a pretty good mix. And look at that, there we go, got more policy score. Fantastic. But you can see in our two encampment cities, we've got the possibility now, I'm just going to move the night out briefly, to start using our faith because we built the McBuilding here. I forget exactly what it's called. Which one is it? The Grandmaster's Chapel. There we go. That lets you buy land units with faith, and actually that's really handy. So in these encampment cities, just double check we've got things like barracks. We don't even have barracks. That's a pretty bad thing. And then let's get the armory in, and let's get the military academy in. There we go. All of these buildings, if we just get all those, effectively what it means is if we spawn in troops now, they're going to get loads of bonuses. And you can see, using faith to buy units is pretty damn effective. Bombards especially will be pretty handy. We can get artillery in a little bit, but for now, we've got 249 faith per turn coming in. Inventory, we can see we can buy an infantry army just like that, off the bat. So there we go, more troops. It's all fantastic. I actually didn't know you could use faith to buy armies. I think that must have been put in the game recently, but that's really, really handy. So as you can see, the next job is to fight Mapushi. We're just kind of moving troops around a little bit, for the sole purpose of actually building armies and things. You can see we've got a couple of new just regular units that have been put in. We've got cores. I'm just moving stuff around. It's actually quite a nice opportunity just to take a couple of turns just to sort my life out. We've also got an observation balloon and look at this, a bombard army. So this is going to start being fantastic. We're on the borders of being able to upgrade to artillery as well. But that's a 3-tile shot, so I should be able to attack the capital from my own territory there, which is pretty damn good. Although speaking of, because I will be attacking from my own territory, I need to make sure that my religion is what I'm following. So I've just built 4 inquisitors just to chuck them around and remove this horrible other religion from my empire. Artillery and battleships. You know, I could use a couple of battleships. I think it's the only way I'm going to get through Australia's Navy because, oh my god, that thing is ridiculous. We are very quickly going to get our alliance. Actually, we can't get our alliance back up with Australia now. Ooh, because we need to keep on their bad side. Yeah, it's the only way. Keep on their bad side for when we go to war with them. You can see I've kind of split my army a little bit. So I've got multiple units down this side near Bangalore. Go away, Russia. And I've got this army here. So I don't know which one is going to be the effective one. We're building up some faith, building up some gold again so I can spawn some troops into locations that they're needed. But generally speaking, yeah, I don't know how this one's going to roll out. But it's time. We can go for another Golden Age War, which is a very easy way of doing that. I mean, oh my god, the war weariness is appalling if you don't do a Golden Age War. So I'm glad we had that as an option. Also, ridiculous how weak our ranged attack in our city is now, so yep, we're gonna have to keep an eye on that. So let's get this started. As long as my infantry army is on the border, I think I'm going to be alright. But let's not forget, I've also got my Bear Grylls unit. He's super tough. Here we go. Right, so I've already killed a veteran enemy. That's a good start. Bear Grylls, in comes Bear Grylls. I think he gets to heal himself, yeah, when he kills a unit, so that's gonna be good fun. I love the fact. It's basically a scout without the dog, isn't it? No dog. I feel like Bear Grylls should get a dog, but that's just me. Field cannons are actually still very effective. I was worried coming into this fight that they were going to be a little bit underwhelming. Oh, I meant to go for the other one there. I don't know why I attacked that one, but actually I do know why I attacked that one. It's because I'm incapable of playing this game. And I forgot that all my field cannons can fire twice. Oh, my army. It's just so good. I forgot how good it was. Hit me with all you've got. Oh, they're attacking my city walls. They're going straight round all my army and attacking them. Why would you do that? Why would you do that? Just so that actually it's really annoying and I always get that pop-up saying, do you want to fix the walls? I reckon that's exactly what they're doing there. I mean, it's a completely silly move because I could just sit here with my troops and go, bang, bang. Do you know what I mean? Like, it's just... what are they doing? Ah, these field cannons are so satisfying. They're just literally parked here on the border. I attack as many times as I want. The one thing I don't have, though, is siege equipment. Now that is a good point. And that is something I should have considered before. What siege equipment is it still possible to buy? None. Okay. Right, so we're going to be very, very heavily reliant on our artillery here. And annoyingly, I've just moved my troops onto all the tiles that I would want. Actually, I can still do this. I moved my artillery onto the airport. Oh, look, they've got an airport. Wow. Well, they're a little bit more advanced than I gave them credit for. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to use my troops to basically surround the cities and make them under siege. So I, you know, they can't heal themselves up. That's always quite nice. I'm also going to give my great general, put him near Bear Grylls. There we go. Attack Bear Grylls at your peril. Ha 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 ha. Here we go. These things are just going to start. I should have done this at the beginning of my turn, to be honest. Get rid of all of this opposing religion. And what that means is that I essentially get my combat strength back. Here we go. 17 population following my religion now. This is how we do it. Oh, it's just so many announcements. Stop it. I've got professional sports. Professional sports is really good because it gives me this a stadium de Macarena, which is actually really good. Plus two amenities in each city. I just need that massively. But I also need stadiums, full stop. So we'll get that in a little bit. But... oh my goodness, it's all just kicking off at the moment. Right, this artillery army getting attacked by raiding units, but I can start, there we go, I can start taking down these walls. I need to defend this. The good thing is now I've got my religion back, I'm actually getting the plus 10 defender of the faith again, which is really good. It helps just these field cannons just on my border. Just keep whittling away at those troops. Oh god, this guy is getting absolutely obliterated. Actually, defending against city attacks, that's a good upgrade for you. Splendid. These field cannons can just keep chipping pointlessly away at the walls, even though it's not going to do anything, really. Actually, just grind experience with these armies. Bear Grylls, what sort of upgrades can we get? Oh, it's the spy ones. Ambush, plus 10. Oh, this is what I want. Plus 20% combat strength in all situations. Right, let's give you faster movement in hills. For now, move this army here. Now, I get the feeling Bear Grylls probably doesn't have a threat range, does he? So I've got to keep an eye on that. Oh, stripping away this enemy religion is just so deeply satisfying. You can see I've just... oh, here we go. I love Bear Grylls. The world is reaching its final stage of appreciation. There's something deeply satisfying about using Gustav Eiffel to build the Eiffel Tower. It's just right, you know? Oh, what's that? Tanks? Supply convoys? I think so. Oh, a naval tradition. I may have forgotten to get naval tradition. Don't judge me. Please don't judge me. Slowly creeping all my troops forward as we realise that actually Fushi doesn't have any army whatsoever to attack us with. Which I think we kind of knew anyway, but my god. It's just so satisfying. Just not even any siege equipment, and I'm doing this the AI way, you know, where you just hit units endlessly into a city for no good reason whatsoever. Satisfying as hell. And at the same time, I'm still getting great writers, because I'm a great person myself, yeah. Just throw that out there. I have to say, I do like all of these little pop-ups. In England, the expression, to spend the afternoon in London means to have a wonderful time. I live in London. I'm not entirely convinced of that phrase's accuracy, let's just put it that way. Oh man, I just keep getting all of these, like, notifications, trade routes being plundered, enemy spy siphon in gold, enemy recruited partisans? What? No, there are tanks. Why are there tanks? Oh god, that's awful. You would have think that I should really just focus on getting, you know, like, actual troops. But no, I'm just gonna buy some more tanks. Enemy tanks being defeated by tanks is the only way. It's the only way we can make sure we're gonna win. Hello, Mr. Artillery. Let's remove that wall. Fantastic, you've done a good job. Done a very good job. Now, field cannons. Just keep grinding experience in the only way you know how. Just repeated shelling of the city, most probably full of innocent people. It's the only way that we can do this. Anyway, after all that, we've got the capital. So, you know, it's not so bad, really. In fact, if we're lucky, we might be able to grind out a double victory this turn. This is a double attacking one. I want to promote this guy. But for now, I'm just going to do that. And then get this. There we go. I think I should be able to take this one as well. There we go. Double city. Two cities in one. Fantastic. Also, I've got a stadium in London. I might have built one. Well, I might have purchased one with the gold I'm supposed to be saving. because, you know, but actually my amenities are looking much better now. 0, 0, 0, 0, -1, 0, +1. I've got a +1, everyone. 0, -3, +2, -1, 0, -1, 0, -1, 0. Yeah, I've never seen it so good. this is actually, like, working out really well now. This is the late stages of the game. It's all coming together. Here comes Bear Grylls. We're going to plunder the trade route. Ah, 50 gold. That was so worth it. Oh, we've got another policy slot. That's quite cool. Let's try out colonial taxes. I'm hoping that should get us a little bit of gold. Yeah, oh my goodness. Yeah, like 200 gold. Whew. It's an often underused policy that's actually very good. Eiffel Tower. Hooray. I built that purely because it gets just absolutely tons of appeal. It's actually really, really handy generally. I'm still getting, like scientists as well. Great. Great Albert Einstein. +4, I think, for universities. This guy's just so good. Oh, fantastic. Yeah, my science is going to get a considerable boost after that one. Also, barbarian tanks. Yeah, we've got to have a word about this. This is not an appropriate use of my time. Whee! Haha, you didn't see that coming, did you? The amount of water parks I'm building is ridiculous. I actually don't think I need anywhere near as many water parks as what I'm building, but I'm doing it because, oh god, amenities in this game are just the limiting factor, I tell you. Oh dear, there's another emergency against me. There we go, they're not going to take back that capital. Let's see who joins in, because I might find myself at war with random people like Nubia and India and stuff. I'm hoping they shouldn't fight me because I've got their capital, so they're less likely to think that they can get away with full-fledged combat, but we'll see how that goes. Also, these god damn it, barbarians, get out of here. Thank you. Really annoying that. Ooh, is that the Kremlin? No, St. Basil's Cathedral. That stuff's good. That stuff's really good. I'm gonna have to go and steal that because, my goodness. Ooh, and we're actually very close to machine guns now as well, which is the field cannon upgrade. And very well needed, actually. Going to see if there's a hidden city here. There is. Oh, and loyalty is an issue for it as well. Let's just rub it in by shelling it with 3 tile, you know, shots. This'll be fine. Actually, do they have another city up here? Oh, I would love it if they have another city up there. Just a little, like, mountain kingdom. I'm so going to just leave that one alone. That's fine. If you want to hide in your mountain kingdom, I give you full permission, Mapushi. That's such a cool little place of the map. Could you imagine the adjacency bonuses for the districts around there? Oh, beautiful. I've got a beach resort, everyone. Hooray! More importantly, uranium. Do I have it? And if not, where is it? It's on the map now, and I can't see a goddamn bit, which is normally my luck. Oh, look, Russia's got some. That's annoying. Anywhere for uranium? I don't think there's any. I don't think I've got any uranium. Oh yeah, Valletta's got some as well. Well, I think we know what's going to be happening there, Valletta. In fact, now that I look at it, Russia's got flipping 2 uranium. Oh my god, Zanzibar, it's where it needed to be all along. It's ridiculous. Anyway, yeah, I'm going to bring my tanks up to Valletta and I'm just going to pay them a visit. Ooh, wabam. Oh, I love artillery armies. They're just so much fun. Anyway, city's mine. That's really cool. I'm going to keep it. It's just a little fantastic little mountain kingdom here. Really awesome. Let's go and see what's over in this direction. Yeah, another city. You know what? I'm going to leave that city alone. I feel like that's fair. That's fair. I want the Paishi to have at least one city in the game still. I am going to just kill this city down here because I want to unlock the passage to Australia for myself. They're the last enemy in the game. I just want to make sure that we've got them covered.